Then there is the most famous dimension of heart, you know, that everybody, you know, long for or have a flavor of heart center, especially the heart itself, the heart center, and the pericardium around the heart, mm-hmm. and the solar plexus, we call it the center of Möbius, of infinity, okay. they produce different qualities or gradations of golden essence. So much heart is associated with gold. Christ, the golden one, I don't know, so many, you know, associated with gold. This center has sweetness, secrete honey-like substance that softens when the chest is softened, when the heart is softened. And I advise everyone who is listening to the tape, massage your heart as we do, massage your chest, go between your ribs, you know, all day long, you know. Circulate, open the thymus gland, open the heart, open the solar plexus. The heart in general produces a sweet nectar. You know, for a seer, it feels like liquid gold, you know, golden quality. Often it's yellowish gold, you know, delicate yellowish gold, sweet. And it has sweet love in it. Cuddly, sweet love. It is something that the baby enjoys, I think, from 2 weeks till maybe 9 months, you know. It's in a continual melted merge state. You see them that they wake up and they smile and maybe fuss a little, then they have a yummy breast nourishment, then they are melted again. What makes them melt? What makes them so soft, make them their flesh as if it is, I don't know, mango or papaya. It's not like ordinary flesh, you know, it's yummy. They are really yummy object. That's why we become cannibalist with them. They are so yummy. So by cannibalists, we can't stop hugging them and kissing them and, you know, eating them up. And this quality of gold, you often see it in the image of Mary and the baby Christ.
Yes.
They have this dual definitely. Unity. They have this sweetness between them. They have this adoration, love, and union, and merging. It has so much of this. We call it merging love, merging essence. It's sweet. It's loving. It's nourishing. It's melting. It has the effect on the system of melting it, of relaxation. You know, most of the time, our system is wind up. Especially in the new world where we are on the highways and on the internet. And we're so wound up, our nervous system, glandular, muscular, all of that.
Or dried up.
Sorry?
Or dried up.
Or dried up. Not even, you know, substance in it. This quality comes and soften it, melt it, gives it relaxation, gives it ease, gives it sweetness, you know. The human body is based on, one of the principles based on is in something called autonomic regulation. You know, the system regulates itself. It builds up a charge of energy, then discharges it, and charge and discharge. You see it in children, you know. They build up their energy, they run around, they come cuddle, you know, snuggle a little bit, they melt or take a nap, and they build up the energy. That's the autonomic regulation. In adulthood, so much we use sexuality and love as a regulation. Sexuality is buildup of a charge, and then orgasm is discharge and melt. If this is allowed, then we're healthy. We have autonomic regulation, our system regulated. Most of the adults depend on this, on sexuality or sexual love or something, to give them this regulation. But through meditation, through opening of those energies, through integrating of essential state, you can get the autonomic regulation independent from sexuality or independent from having to love or not to love. You know, it becomes qualities of energy or essence passing through your body. One gives them one gives the body the energy of, charge, you know, build up of charge, and the other one gives it melting. Gold gives it melting, yeah? And I will come to the one that gives it charge. But first, let me come to the gold.
Okay.
Gold has variety of densities. It can be very delicate, like in babies. Delicate gold, you know, their system is not so dense, it's very supple. Then gold can become richer, not just yellow, or yellow, but denser, almost like spongy, or like a solid gold. Sometimes gold get mixed up with other qualities, become like amberic gold, richer kind of gold, not just, you know, like this kind of gold instead of yellow gold, you know. In general, yellow is more of the golden qualities. I have my supply with me, it's of essence. You know, people wonder why I use beads, because they remind me of essence. It's not religious. You know, that's my religion.
Yeah.
So sometimes gold becomes amberic in nature. And when gold becomes amberic in nature, it produces different quality of love than melting love, than merging love. It brings precious love. You know, when you feel like, you know, sometimes you just, that person is so precious to you, or that object is so precious to you. And when this amber gold come inside, you begin to experience a love for everything and how precious everything is. You know? Most of the time, we look at things and treat things without sense of preciousness, you know? Well, even the material universe, we just misuse it and abuse it and, you know, consume it and throw it away. You know, animals, we don't care for them except maybe to eat or something like that. Forests we burn, rivers we pollute, air we don't give a damn as long as you have. This kind of love make you feel air is so precious. You know, every cell in your body is so precious. It fills you with this sense of preciousness. And that's why in Tibet, they have every guru, they call them Rinpoche, precious ones. Why are they precious? Because they are the embodiment of the human being. We as human beings nowadays are not human beings. We are 75% alien, ego, personality issues, dryness, all of those things, and 25% essence and beauty and love and richness. While those Rinpoches have awakened, enlightened, and recognized that the most precious thing is our being, the human being, and that every human being is made of something precious, you know, essential element, energies that are so profound, different from the energy produced by ego and frustration. These are negative emotional state, negative biochemical state, negative essential state. So when you awaken more and more to this golden preciousness, golden rich love, you begin to value who you are. You begin to value everybody. That's why the Dalai Lama said, no, but the Chinese people, these are people. We can't harm them because the government have politicians. You know, have politics, you know. So this awakens in the human being the preciousness of who you are. You really love yourself preciously, including your ego with all its offness. You feel, yes, it did the best it could. You know, I'm not going to destroy it. It's really, it's precious. It's like a child in me who didn't know what to do and did its best, you know. So you feel, okay, I have to heal this child. I have to modify this ego. I have to upgrade my, you know, my personality, but out of love. Then another aspect of this golden love becomes even more than just amber gold. It becomes copper gold. Becomes almost red amberic gold, very solid. And this is, it feels as if your heart is not just a delicate heart. It's not a sweet, loving heart. It is a lion heart. It is a solid heart, you know, and this heart loves truth. It's the love of truth. It's the love of being. Once you realize that our being is so beautiful, so wonderful, it is, that's why people worship it, call it God, you know. It is our being, it is the human being. Once you reach that being, you realize it is made of elements of truth. One aspect of its manifestation is truth. And you fall in love with truth. You don't accept anymore your ego and it want to twist the world and want to make it falsify reality. And you don't want even your lies, you know. I remember when I started the spiritual journey, my biggest motivation wasn't to awaken spiritually for the sake of awakening. I wanted to get rid of my ego. I remember in 66, I had it with my ego. I felt, you know, I was 4 on the Enneagram. I felt I had enough dosage of suffering. You know, I either, you know, get rid of it or I die. But nothing else, of course, 4 is drama. You know, but I really do want this ego because I felt this ego was always distorting reality, you know? Like even to something very personal, like I might feel a feeling, you know? And before I did therapy, before I started bioenergetic therapist, if I had a feeling, it'll be like a disaster for, I don't know, a week, you know, oi, 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 oi. Suffering and suffering. And it might even bring an Indian movie to watch so I could intensify my drama. You know, Indian movies are great for drama and suffering.
The good old, to know.
You know, oh yeah, not the Bollywood, the old ones, you know, every element of suffering are condensed in a 3 hours movie, you know. So you have to have a box of Kleenex next to you. And I had it enough with myself. I felt this self was not serving the truth. When I went in bioenergetic and started to feel the feeling, what was it? I was feeling sad or hurt. And when I felt it, it felt like a little contraction in the heart. No big deal. Yeah. But my ego was blowing the trumpets about it. You know? And when I felt it, I could cry a little or I could just sigh a little and it goes away. You know? Then I saw that my ego is not into truth. My ego is into its narcissistic supply. You know, making every situation as a supply, as a nourishment. Then I realized, oh, this is my relationship with my mother. You know, if I suffer, she will love me. If she suffers, I will love her. So we are suffering as a nourishing exchange, you know. To suffer, you know, God bless her soul. She used to say, my son, hell with humanity is paradise. So I said, okay, I join you. Left my golden universe to sit with her in suffering. Aww. Because it's paradise. But this kind of longing for merging, for union, made us even leave our truth, the golden truth, the shining truth, the lion-heartedness to stand for the truth and to say the emperor is naked. Humanity is off. You know, they are really messed up reality and truth. And this is the solid copper gold, give you the courage, give you the love to want the truth and to shine in the truth, because you know the truth is sustaining us, providing for us, and that my spirit without the truth will be lost in karma and in psychological nightmares and issues. So the truth becomes my salvation, my belovedness, the God that's, you know, nourishing and providing and all of that. So then it replaces mother and, you know, becomes the, you know, the absolute becomes mother and father. You know?
I just want to say there, Faisal, yes, that your capacity to stay with someone suffering is the most extraordinary gift.
Thanks. Thanks, really. With this really comes that I love the truth in them. I see that in their suffering, it's birthing their essence, you know. While before I would spend 20 sessions just oi, 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 oi. They cry and I cry. You know, it doesn't work. Now I'm not afraid to feel the hurt, and because I know the pain inside is not as exaggerated as the reality. You know, when we were children, our heart was tender. And its first wounds are devastating for a baby. But now we are mostly calloused. Little hurt is no big deal, you know? But the ego tried to make it big deal, trying to retake us to that tender heart. But it doesn't happen that way. Through the goldenness, tender heart, sweetness heart, begin to open, then lion-heartedness come, the love of the truth, the cover gold heart. So this is another aspect of the golden domain. You know, it has so many rich domains, and people relate to love as most often gold, and gold sometimes mixed with passion. Sometimes melting gold, you just want to cuddle and snuggle with your beloved and melt in their arms. And sometimes, no, you want to cuddle and snuggle and then have passion and make love and melt and cuddle and get mixed, you know, with all of those things. Copper gold is a mixture of red essence and black essence and gold, you know. Uh-huh. And so is amber, you know, okay. Mix of red and yellow gold. When they mix, they become amberic, and black and yellow gold makes, and red makes copper gold. This is where alchemy come in the picture. You know, alchemy is a combination of essential states. Even though I am talking about them linearly now, but they sometimes get mixed, and that's called, you know, alchemy. In Arabic, the word for it is mizaj. Mizaj means mood. I am in ecstatic, passionate mood. I am in tender mood. These moods usually are mixture. The word mood in Arabic literally means mixture. Mixture of this quality, red and gold, white and red, and all of those produces variety of different essential states. So essential states are not linear. For the people who are in the essential domain or spiritual domain, be open to this turbulence, to this mixture, you know, kneading and doughing. First get the elements, get the water and the, I don't know, wheat and all of this, then knead them, then bake them, you know, you have something totally different, you know. And we are aiming at that bread. But first we're gonna gather the elements. In my invocation of the different qualities, I wanna tenderize the listener's system. I want them to feel different qualities of love running in their body, in their heart, in their mind, in their veins, in their flesh. And all of this is a preparation for that jewel heart.
Okay.
So I first want to knead them, like do the aerobics, then we do the, okay, hopefully, you know, the final transmission of love.
Beautiful.
So where